You have no right to detain us.
We got a call that a baby was being kidnapped. Nobody told us you were involved. Somehow I'm not surprised.
Shut up, okay? My son was kidnapped, and you're angry at us? What the hell is wrong with you people?
All we want to do is help. If someone took your baby, we'll do our best to
find
him.
That's okay. We'll take care of ourselves. Thank you very
much. When the law is broken, it's up to the police to find the perpetrator. That is the system we live under, Mr. Morgan. No matter
what,
Mr.
Please make it fast!
Watch you! Tell me the last time you saw your baby, please.
Right here. He was in his stroller 1 minute, and then he was gone.
Miss Roberts, I realize this must be very, very difficult for you. But the more you can tell us, the better chance we'll have of finding your son.
I was walking through the lobby, and the clerk at the desk stopped me. Said I had a phone call from Mr. Edward Quartermain.
Did you find that unusual?
He's called before.
Then what?
I went to the phone, and nobody was there.
You left the baby unattended?
I was right there. I was right there. I only
turned my back. Garcia, that's enough. She told you what she knows. Now leave her alone.
That's not your decision to make, Mr. Morgan. You mind stepping over here for a moment?
No, no, I'm not going anywhere with you.
Look, if you're in a hurry, this will make it go by faster.
Thank you. You brought this on yourself, Hotshot. Leaving the baby and his mother alone, unprotected.
What? Don't!
Let's start from the beginning. Did you see any of this at all, or were you too busy shopping for your new wardrobe?
And that was it? Then you saw your baby was gone?
Look, I told you everything I know, okay? I'm sorry, I need to be alone for a minute.
Don't go far.
You're in the business of making enemies, Mr. Morgan. My take is that somebody decided to play dirty.
Is that all you're gonna do, just stand around here and make guesses?
Hey, look, this case is gonna be handled according to strict guidelines established by forensic kidnapping experts. So before we start running off with our weapons drawn, we will wait for the kidnappers to contact you. And I can guarantee you, if it's a ransom they want, we won't have long to wait.
What about the press?
For now, we keep it quiet.
All right, fine. I want the opportunity to look for Michael myself without
interference. No, no way.
Why not?
No way.
You're not up to it. You make a mistake, which you will, everybody is going to blame us.
Detective.
The clerk?
Yes.
Mr.
Carter.
Mr. Carter, I'm Detective Garcia. This is Detective Taggert, Port Charles Police Department. Can you tell us about how many people know what happened here this afternoon?
Me, two bellmen, that's it.
No guests?
It was a slow time of day. The lobby was empty.
Good, good, good. Are you married, Mr. Carter?
Yes.
You keep secrets from your wife?
Occasionally.
Well, you're about to keep another one. In order for us to solve this case and possibly save a baby's life, we're going to need complete secrecy on your part. That means no one knows what happened here this afternoon. Not your wife, your boss, your best friend, your priest, no one. Can you do that, Mr. Carter?
You have my word.
Tell them if they breathe a word to anyone, I will personally pursue criminal charges against them.
I'm certain that will get their attention.
I'm sure it will. Look, tell your men to clear out. I don't want anyone getting suspicious.
Okay.
Can we go now?
Not yet. Miss Roberts, as we've just explained to Mr. Morgan, we're treating this case as a kidnapping for ransom. I want you to keep this completely to yourself until further notice. Is that clear?
Sure.
You got a read on this, Taggart?
Not yet.
Mr. Roberts said the Quartermain family tried to steal the baby once. You think it's possible they went after him again?
Maybe. My take is this is more about Morgan's business relations. Word on the street is he's been getting a little resistance lately. This may be a way of keeping him in line.